things. I'd love if you shared the organ failure and all of that. Yeah. That's people can maybe or maybe not relate to if they didn't get that bad. But hold on, check it out. You have, at the White House, yeah. and then you ended up yes. with all your degrees, all yeah. of that. You yeah. were, what, packing shelves?
At yeah. Oh, packing bags at Whole Foods.
So.
Oh, packing groceries. Gosh, talk about.
yeah. But how did you, like, it's one thing, like, if you just get given, like, I yeah. mean, you're about to die, you're in a hospital, is that. But we forget that the bigger, like, challenge yeah. sometimes is yeah. that humbling yeah. to just go, oh, wow. I'm going to have to. I have all these degrees. I've got. Oh, I've been with President Obama. Yeah. I've been yeah. in the White House, yes, yes, and now yes. I'm packing groceries.
I was working at the White House with the Clinton administration, and I that you know that was you know the beginning of my career. That was my mm-hmm. first job out of high school, and I really thought that this is you know I was from that point on that anybody who hadn't worked at the White House I was better than, and I had this like this huge ego and yeah. and went around and that ego unfortunately kept me sick for a very long time. And it wasn't until I got beaten into a state of submission, beaten into a state of surrender, through enough pain. I had to go through pain in order to make this decision. Because if it wasn't painful, I wouldn't have looked for a solution. I would have stuck around. But you know, it was enough pain, and actually it transformed into suffering. Because you know, they say that you know, suffering is pain that we are powerless to change. And when I saw that I could no longer do anything about this pain in my life, this addiction in my life, there was no more ways for me to manage my health or keep myself alive and still use drugs and alcohol. It is only then when I was given through the gift of desperation another way out, and I decided to search, and that's when I ended up at Father Martin's. I ended up, finding light that had been, you know, that essentially had been lit by others. Because what we do, the work that I do, is really just lighting a fire in other people's hearts, mm-hmm. and letting them go out and light the fire in others. You know, that is we're just passing on the torch. You know, yep. passing on the motive to change and do great things and find that within themselves. You know, that has. That will enable them to be and do all that they thought they could that they couldn't do before, and the thing is that even though I was very accomplished then, now that I've done the work, now that I've gotten rid of and have uncovered, discovered, and discarded so many self-limiting beliefs and things about myself and all of that, now I am even though I have multiple felonies, multiple rehabs, my vision is so much grander than it was when I thought I was accomplished. You know, it was so much grander than when I was, you know, working, you know, at the hedge fund and working at the White House and thought that, you know, that I was still limited. My world was very small. Now I see, you know, this entire planet truthfully needs help. Each of us can need help and yeah. can use help. We're all human. We all can benefit from someone else reaching out a hand, someone else, you know, helping us out when we're in need, someone else passing on something that has helped them. Yep. And that's why I say we're uniquely qualified to make a difference in other people's lives, regardless of what we've been through.